Alright, so we're on to, is this winners finals? Trucks and Gerald.
Hello there.
This is what we wanted to see. This is actually the closest matchup in our scene this season. Whoever takes this set and, you know, or like has a really good chance of taking this tournament, because they'll be moving on to grand finals and, you know, still have those two chances to win. That's not to say that either one of these guys would take home the gold, but yeah, that's how it's, how likely it's looking. Whoever does that has a really good chance of being higher on the PR.
Okay.
At the, you know, after next week. I'm not gonna say too much else, but I actually think this is 1000% the closest that we've got so far. I think they're 10-8 in set count.
Jeez, really?
And they've both got 5 tournament wins each. So this is going to be a super, super close one. Gerald and Trucks played so much this season. I actually think they've played the most sets with each other out of anybody else.
Well, how many rounds have we had this season so far?
How many tournaments?
Yeah.
That's a really good question. I don't know off the top of my head.
Okay.
But they've played 18 sets.
Yeah.
Which we've had a lot less tournaments than that.
There's only a 2 like difference. Like 2-point difference.
Yeah, only a 2-set difference.
Who's in that in favor of?
I believe it's in favor of Trucks.
Okay.
I could be wrong though.
So Trucks starting off with a good lead using his Squirtle very nicely here.
Mm. Yeah, doing a great job of
swapping to the Ivy, getting a nice nair for an edge guard.
Yeah, and Gerald has no jump here. Makes it back.
He's got that big up B though, which is always just so dangerous because it just sucks you in. And yeah, hip. Ooh.
And Trucks coming in with that back air, just only on 50% here too, so.
Nice early lead for him.
Yeah.
It's a weird interaction.
Yeah, Gerald knocking the Trucks off the stage, but.
Trucks is really enjoying these Squirtle up B's since last week.
Yeah.
When I saw him playing.
Nah, he's on any character, he's a big fan of doing up B's, like grounded up B's to get damage and things like that. Like, when we saw his Cloud, he just spammed up B for a whole tournament.
I remember when he
played Cloud. And it was god awful. But comes in there, reads that air dodge, and gets it the back air.
Gerald actually having to use his neutral bees a little bit.
Mm. Yeah, Gerald's been doing a really good job, like catching people's recoveries with those neutral bees, trying to get those 2 frames.
Something that's so scary about the flare blitz is even if it misses, it sends like Charizard just so far that you need a character with as much run speed as Chrom to catch up to it.
Oh, definitely.
And then punish it. Because if you shield it, then like that's an easy punish, but. It's just so difficult sometimes with like how well he uses it. Like I've seen him use it and just go like through the platform but over his opponent.
Yeah.
So that way he can just like freely land on the ground half the stage away, barely even get punished for it.
And then the other thing too with the side B is that you feel like you should punish this because it's such a laggy move, and you know, it really makes you scramble for that punish, so you know. Someone like Gerald is not going to get too flustered by that.
Yeah.
But, you know.
He is also probably going to take the safest approach.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, and Trucks makes it back.
Yeah.
Good use of Gerald. Switching. Trying to get those F tilts in there.
Oh.
Very wow, nice trying to chase there, but gets another F tilt there and takes that game one.
I don't think that was even the sweet spot either.
No, it wasn't.
It's just how strong that move can be.
So, great work there from Trucks. Taking that game one.
Hmm.
And Gerald, that wasn't super close, but at the same time, Gerald like, definitely not down and out.
Like, physically looking at him, you can see that Gerald isn't too, like, taken aback.
Yeah.
He's keeping his calm.
It's like, it's game one.
Yeah. You know. It's game one winners finals. I've still got a whole tournament to go.
Yeah, exactly. Well, you know, Gerald's still sitting pretty in winners.
Yeah.
You know, he knows that his biggest threat in this tournament is facing him down as well as also the biggest threat. So,
yeah.
You know, he's not too worried about this. Game two might tell a different story.
Well, what stage do they pick? I didn't actually see.
Oh, it looks like they're going to town. So this would be Gerald's pick.
Yeah.
Gerald liked this against Mia earlier. Yeah. Mm.
He just has a lot of move to run around with his crumb.
Yeah. Definitely. So.
He has those platforms that he can easily hide on as well.
Great little grab there from Trucks.
Good DI from Gerald getting out of that. Because that can be really tricky to DI, because you have to DI with, like, if he goes for the forward air, you have to DI it down, but if he goes for the back air, I think you have to DI out.
Yeah.
I could be wrong on that, though. I haven't actually fought Trucks often, or, like, very recently.
Yeah, that's fair enough. I feel like a lot of these players that are ranked more highly, like, they have a lot more matchups against the other
high-ranked players.
Just through nature.
Oh, wow, really?
That was crazy. What a snipe. And Trucks, starting off this second game pretty much the same way that he started the first, only 50% to his name, and already taken a stock off of Gerald.
Trucks just trying to keep his distance and keep his lead a bit, but
Gerald's
down tilts.
Chases him across the stage there. Trucks getting that fair, but the swap back to the Squirtle too. Interesting choice. Or misses the jacket.
He does also use those switches really good, because it's pretty much just a free lagless air dodge. Like air dodge in place, and then you're just an entirely different character to worry about.
Yeah. And you know, there's some really nice things about some up B's, how they, you know, keep you relatively safe if you're spamming them. Squirtles is not one of those, and Gerald punishes that accordingly. Oh,
missing the air dodge into the stage.
That's really unfortunate. Gerald missing that air dodge to come back to the stage.
Going for it. It's just going for down throw offense. Playing a lot of footsies right now.
Yep.
Both players just trying to get a good in, but they also have such good frame data that it's just hard to, like, keep them there.
Yeah.
Keep them in, like, these kind of strings and everything.
Definitely.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Nice air dodge from Gerald, avoiding the up B.
Yeah, but it might even be a little bit too little too late. Trucks has a lot of percent on Gerald. And there the down air.
And even if he didn't get that down air, I don't think he would have grabbed ledge there.
I don't think so. This is looking pretty strong here from Trucks. Gerald has the face of, should I pick Sephiroth? And I reckon he's probably going to.
He's got pure determination right now.
Yeah, cracks a smile. He's made his decision. You can see it ticking over. Gerald looking at that Bowser Jr.
pocket, which Koopaling will
pocket
he
BJ
pick?
From Gerald here.
Pokemon trainer.
Having a laugh. You can see him like. He's kind of like, oh, should I move over to that Chrom? Thinking about this Lucario, a Pokemon to challenge the other Pokemon. Lucario definitely been top tier in some metas, but
have we had a player who plays Lucario?
We've had a couple of people dabble in Lucario, but nobody that's actually picked him up as a main.
Yeah. He's just so hard to stick with, just because the aura makes him so inconsistent.
Yeah, definitely. But Gerald making that swap to the Sephiroth, hoping that this is what it takes to start the reverse sweep he now has to complete to make it to Grands.
I've got a bit of a prediction for this. I feel like Trucks isn't going to stick to Charizard much for this one. just because the other two are so small, they can kind of like dance around the massive hitboxes that Sephiroth can throw out.
Yeah.
So if I was in Trux's shoes right now, I would be heavily trying to rely on Squirtle dealing a lot of damage real quickly. He didn't actually make it.
That's really unfortunate there. He got that up air to sort of cover himself on the way up, but then just didn't make it back to the stage. And, you know, even though Trux didn't actually take the stock, it was more of an SD this time, we still find him in the exact same position as the first two games. Only 50%
the man is full of consistency.
And his whole stock up. Alright, Gerald getting that grab. Wow, trying to snuff out that recovery. That scares me every single time he does that. Great parry there. Gerald getting away all of that pressure from Trux's Ivysaur. Yeah, swaps to the Charizard, but that extra bulk enough to help him live.
He does have to be careful because, like I said before, he's just so massive and Gerald's hitboxes are pretty much the size of Charizard tail to head.
And I was super surprised that Charizard got hit there and didn't, Sephiroth didn't stab into the stage. That was crazy, but the back air there, sealing that stock for Gerald.
That was something I saw Gerald and Ben actually go trade for trade with their very quick back airs. Oh,
the down smash punish on that up B there.
He's also, his smash attacks are also... Are his smash attacks actually stronger, or is it just super armor?
I think they're a little bit stronger, but yeah, they do definitely have the super armor when you have the wing.
Oh, nice armor from Trux there.
Yeah. And Gerald, using the power of this wing, has really brought things back. Throw there from Trux.
If he does, get... Oh, wow, not actually going for the up there.
Yeah. I don't know whether... Yeah,
He might have thought he still had this jump, but he didn't. Scintilla not coming out properly.
Yeah, but, Trux will take that to the bank every day. And, uses that neutral B in his favor there. Gets a little bit of extra damage on Gerald when Gerald thought he was safe.
Ooh, that could have been very dangerous from both bodies.
Yeah.
They were just a bit closer together.
That interaction was definitely going to be interesting. Wow. Trux going hard on that.
The wing's coming back out.
Yeah, wing's back out now, and... This could be kind of scary for Trux, but
Gerald does need to play very carefully.
Yeah.
And the thing is, if he kills Trux if he kills Trux now, he's not going to keep his wing. I think he needs to be at about 100 to keep it, but I could be wrong on that.
Okay. Yeah, I didn't realize that was a percentage-based thing. I just thought it was being strange. But damn, that forward throw, and Trux takes this set 3-0.